Hello everyone. So, I have this ESP32 and I got it connected to my Wi-Fi network. But after connecting it to the network, I wonder, where is it? I mean, it's right there on the table, but in the network. What IP address does it have? I have an old desktop running on Ubuntu. It used to be Windows, but I had to update that every now and then. And I didn't like that. If I connect to that desktop and run the command screen-ls, it will show me all the screens running on that machine. Let's connect to the one responsible for discovering ESP devices. It is a Python script that counts down for some amount of seconds, then does a discovery and finds my car's charger relay. Let's hop into the script. No actual code here, but we can see the countdown parts and the module where the discovery is executed, which is where we will look next. I added a name is main block to the module for testing. It calls the local subnet function, which does three things. Get our own IP address, make a list of all IPs in our local subnet, check all of those if there is an ESP device. Now let's run this and see what happens. Here we have the IP address I got from my router. This is a list of possible IPs other devices could have gotten from the router. For each of the IPs, a thread was created to connect to the IP and ask for a specific URL. If there was a correct response, the device was added to the list. In my case, it is an ESP that controls the relay to my car's charger. My Wi-Fi network is a TP-Link deco mesh with multiple access points. Any device on the Wi-Fi can access the internet without a problem. But devices cannot find each other, unless I ping the device first. And that is a problem. Instead of my desktop trying to contact all possible ESP32 devices at once, and then waiting for a response, I want all my ESP devices to contact a tiny server and tell it where they are. So my desktop can just ask the server for a list of all devices and receive that list instantly. Let's have a look at the code for the ESP device. I added some libraries by including the header file at the top of the program. The first line allows the ESP to connect to a Wi-Fi network. The second line allows us to connect to an unencrypted web server. And the last line does the same, but for encrypted web servers. After that, some credentials for my local Wi-Fi network. Then a server and a port where the ESP can find my small server. It is a local or non-public server, so HTTP will do just fine. Then the name of the device. And a unique token, to make sure that only I can update and discover my devices. The concept behind this is very simple and almost bulletproof. Each token will have its own storage, so if I don't have your key, then I cannot see your devices, or modify them. To make life easier, I just create an encrypted and unencrypted object at the same time. The setup code is nothing new. Just connect to the Wi-Fi and log some details to the terminal. I want the phone home routine to run every 10 minutes. To do this, I cut up time in 10-minute segments. This integer will contain the current segment number. The ESP will start counting in milliseconds at boot time and starts with 0. So the first 10 minutes from boot, this line will calculate to 0 for the current segment. And as soon as the current segment number changes, we phone home. Which is why I started with segment minus 1. So the first segment triggers the routine right at the start. Next, we have two blocks of code, almost identical, one for HTTPS and one for HTTP. If the hostname contains HTTPS, we create a new buffer big enough to contain everything after that, and then copy that part into the buffer. Like this. Now we have a hostname. We try to connect to it. And if that succeeds, log that and do the actual request to the server. This looks a bit messy, but it is how we talk to web servers. This part is the page on the web server we want. That page will be responsible for registering our ESP device. We then add our name, IP and token as parameters for that page. Look at it as sending a post-it with details to that page. This is the actual talk to the server. Get me that page, please support this version of protocol. Get me that page, please support this version of protocol. You are this host, are you? And close the door after yourself. Then finally, we read the server's response and dump it to serial, line by line. And skip the return codes to keep the log a bit cleaner. And then we close the door. Here we have the server, written in Python. Focus here is on the interaction between ESP and server. We can see the ESP has connected to the Wi-Fi network and decided it is time to phone home. This here is the complete URL the ESP has requested from the server. Everything is there. The database is in this file here. Let's have a look. Yes, it is all there. Now for the server code. Just like on the Arduino, here on the top is where we add our libraries. Then at the bottom of the script, we create a server object running at localhost and port 7000, with a custom URL handler called myRequestHandler. We immediately call serve forever on it. The server object is called httpd in this short scope. This is the URL handler class. And we implemented the server's get method. That was an option we specified when actually talking from ESP to server. We then look at the path in the request, so we can handle different pages. There is another page down here. The parameters we sent to the page have to be unpacked. This parse QS is one way to do this. Here we do the actual extraction of the parameters and give them a value of none if they do not exist. Now, if any of the parameters is missing, we throw a server error back to the ESP. Then we create a dictionary type object with the IP address and a timestamp. We do that with this little helper function. This is another dictionary object called devices. It is empty by default. If, however, there is a file on disk, then we load that file into the dictionary. Here is a check if we already have our own secret storage in the dictionary, and if not, create it on the spot. In the secret spot, we add or update the record we have made earlier, and then write the file back to disk. Finally, we send a "everything is okay" message back to the ESP. Now, we can fire up a browser and go to a different URL on the tiny server. And it will return a list of devices. How cool is that? In a future video, I will integrate this into the ESP32 user interface project. Thank you for watching.